Welcome to the introductory lesson. Today there will be a little historical background. Information about the structure of the GCP library. Examples of animations. As well as the most beautiful sites created using GreenSock technologies from experienced developers. I strongly recommend that you watch this lesson to the end. It will become your motivation in the upcoming training. Are you ready? Let's go! Meet Jack Doyle, an employee of a large advertising firm. Lots of work. Endless animation, banner ads, performance, size requirements, and so on. Well, you understand how it all happens. And in those days, the most popular technology for creating web animation was Flash. Many people remember that the animation worked after pressing a button on the player. A lot has changed since then. And in those days, Jack created an engine that made animation easier and faster. Then he posted it on the blog and wrote something like,
"Here, if somebody else can benefit from this, here you go, give it a shot."
And then it began to gain popularity. People kept asking for add-ons, tweaks and features. Some of them offered money. They just wanted to make sure this thing would continue to work in the future. Jack remained committed. However, success didn't come overnight. Years passed before he was able to move away from his main job. Over time, user support was required. Increasingly, people asked the same questions. And for the 20th time repeating in the answers, Jack came to the concept of the forum. GreenSock wouldn't be where it is today, if it wasn't for the forums. The community grew, and development began to take into account the ideas of users. The number of posts on the forum has already exceeded 100,000. You should definitely take a look at this. GSAP is a tool that people use to do amazing things. Thousands of examples. Answers to questions. The ability to ask your own question and immediately get a solution to the problem. Ready-made examples with many special effects. A lot of everything. These are original scrollings, 3D blanks, morphs, parallaxes. This is a whole ocean of creativity created by users and support. I'll show you just a tiny dab of it. If you are interested, links to the source code of the animations are attached to the lesson. But before you begin to deal with this, I strongly recommend that you take this course. And one more small note. Now is the time to move from the history to the structure of the GSAP library. A few words about versions. To date, many examples have been created using the old version of the library. I'll show you the difference. Outdated version of GSAP includes several modules in its core structure. The core of the new version is one file. And now examples of syntax. Now, it is not necessary to delve deeply into this. We will analyze everything in detail in the next lessons. I want you to catch the following picture. These are signs of an outdated version of the library. And most likely, you are studying something created using the second version of GSAP. And this is a sign that you are working with a new version of the library, with a merged core and updated syntax. Consider the components of GSAP. The structure of the library can be divided into two parts. The first is represented by the core. And this is the main subject of your study. We will study in detail the properties and methods of the core tools. Consider the plugins built into the core. Work with many types of ESS. As well as try useful methods when building animation examples. The second part is represented by additional plugins that require separate download and registration. More complex type of easing, as well as a library fragment that involves joining the Green Sock Club and paid commercial use of some add-ons. It is worth noting that this part can be found free of charge in the online CodePen editor. If you need a complete list of components, you can find it on the Green Sock website at this link. Well, in the final part of this lesson, I will show some examples of sites created using GSAP. Such sites regularly receive awards. And there is something to see, something to learn, and use it as inspiration. The technology stack used to create animation is not limited to the GSAP library. It is worth noting the excellent compatibility of the Green Sock library with other web development technologies. I think I managed to interest you, and you will take this chance to plunge into the amazing world of web animation with GSAP.